So good afternoon, all of you. We are going to discuss about the Atmanirbhar package, which has been declared by the government recently. And we have seen that because of this lockdown, many economic sectors have been affected by this lockdown. And not only lockdown, even before the lockdown, the Indian economy was facing a problem of economic, what you can say, the deceleration. The economic growth has been reduced. So government was looking for some measures to revive the Indian economy. So by finding out the reasons, by the causes why the economic growth has been decelerated, government has decided some, what you can say, the reforms. And that reforms has been, what you can say, named as Atmanirbhar package. So when the word Atmanirbhar package is mentioned, Atmanirbhar package means that the government wants to, what you can say, that India should make, India should become reliant or the self-reliant. And we should, what you can say, try to manufacture whatever the goods and services required for the Indian economy in India itself. And rather than, we can say that we should, what you can say, have import substitution, like we should not import unnecessary, what you can say, the things. And rather than importing, we should try to manufacture all those goods and services within the domestic boundary of a country. That is the overall idea. So as a part of that Atmanirbhar package, what government has decided, what were the economic reforms have been decided by the government, that we are going to discuss. And also the Atmanirbhar package, which has been declared by the government, whether it is sufficient or not, or is there any issues with the Atmanirbhar package, which has been declared by the government, that we are going to discuss today. Right? So I'm sharing you one document, which will be helping us in understanding the Atmanirbhar package. So this Atmanirbhar package comes in paper 3. So here there are the topics which is there in the UPSC exam, in the mains exam, that is General Studies paper 3. There are certain topics in General Studies paper 3. These are, that is, the first topic is Indian economy. What we need to study in the first topic of the Indian economy, that is issues related to planning, then mobilization of resources, growth, development and employment. So these are the important topics which you need to study regarding the Indian economy. So this Atmanirbhar package is trying to solve some of the problems related to the planning of the country, then some of the problems related to the mobilization of the resources of the country. And it has also tried to address the issue of the growth of the economy. And it has also tried to develop some, what you can say, the some infrastructure in the rural areas and in the agricultural sector, as well as in some other sectors that we are going to see. And we're also going to see that how this is going to help in increasing the employment of the country. The next important topic in the syllabus is inclusive growth. Inclusive growth means what? The fruits of the economic growth should reach to the each and every section of the society. So this Atmanirbhar package tries to give some of the measurements or tries to give some of the incentives to the vulnerable sections like migrant workers, farmers, then what you can say, the women, not BPL, what you can say, the people and those who are not having ration card. For them also, government is having some policies in this Atmanirbhar package. Then we'll also see the major crops and cropping pattern is a topic. Budgeting is a different topic. We will see about the government budgeting later on. But in this Atmanirbhar package, major crops and cropping patterns, in that this Atmanirbhar package is trying to help through e-technology in the aid of farm, in the aid of farmers. And also this Atmanirbhar package tried to solve some of the issues related to transport and marketing of the agricultural produce. Right, so this is again one of the very, very important issue which the Indian economy is facing, that is the issues related to transport and marketing of the Indian agriculture. So this topic is also going, we are going to discuss about it today. And again, there are some issues also related to the agricultural, what you can say, the prices. So issues related to minimum support price and also the issues related to the agricultural market or the price mechanism. So in that also the government has decided some, what you can say, the reforms that also we are going to discuss. And we are also going to discuss that the government has also supported something for the food processing, and government has decided, what you can say, agro-processing economies or agro-processing activities in the rural area. So this is also there in the paper 3. So for that regard also, there are many, what you can say, the initiatives taken by the government in this Atmanirbhar package, especially in the supply chain management. So here there is one topic in the economy that is called a supply chain management. So the government has tried to focus more on that supply chain management also, that we will discuss about it. Okay. And some of the laws related to land reforms have been also made. Some of the changes in the land policy on the land acquisition policy have been, what you can say, made in this Atmanirbhar package that we will discuss about it. Because to become Atmanirbhar, our industry should get easy access to the land. Our what you can say, the industries should be able to acquire the land easily so that they can start the new industries in India. Then last is effect of liberalization on the Indian economy. We can say that after the liberalization and globalization of the Indian economy, we can say that economic growth has been increased. But there were some adverse effects also. So to stop those adverse effects, like for example, many people are arguing that if we have become, what you can say, over-dependent on Chinese economy, we have become over-dependent on Iranian economy, we have become over-dependent on American economy. So rather than becoming dependent on the other economies, we should try to become Atmanirbhar in terms of our oil imports, in terms of our, what you can say, machineries import, in terms of, what you can say, the raw material imports. So that is what is expected as a Atmanirbhar package. So we'll also going to see effects of these changes in the industrial policy and on the industrial growth. So this is also we are going to discuss in this topic, right? So all these topics of paper 3 can be covered under the Atmanirbhar package. Means or the government has made certain changes or certain initiatives in those sectors. In this Atmanirbhar package also, government has made certain changes or certain reforms in the infrastructure sector also, especially in the airports and what you can say, the ports and energy sector. So that also we are going to discuss. Yes, and there are some investment models also. Am I audible to all of you?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So there are some investment models like public-private partnership. So government has tried to create some reforms in the airport sectors through public-private partnership. So that also we are going to discuss today. Okay. So first we will try to see what is the Atmanirbhar package which was announced by Prime Minister. So what is Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan announced by PM Modi, that we are going to discuss. So as per the Prime Minister Narendra Modi, who announced an economic package totaling around 20 lakh crore. So government has declared about the 20 lakh crore rupees economic package to tide over the COVID-19 crisis under the Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan. So whatever the problems were being faced by the Indians during that COVID-19, what you can say, the pandemic and the crisis, which has, what you can say, which has laid down to lockdown of the economic activities. And because of that, the economic growth have been stopped. The economic activities have been stopped. So to revive the economy, the government has declared the 20 lakh crore rupees, what you can say, the economic package. PM Modi said that economic package would be around 10% of the total GDP. So he also said that this 20 lakh crore rupees will be, what you can say, the 10% of the total GDP. It means what? That 10% of the total GDP will be spent on the reviving the Indian economy or on this Atmanirbhar package. Can anybody tell me what is the total GDP of India now? What is the total size of the GDP of India? Yes?
2.8 trillion.
Okay, fine. Okay, so what is the 10% of the 2.8 trillion? How much it becomes? Any idea? 2.8 trillion sa 10% kiti hoto? It becomes around 20 lakh crore. Okay? Anyways, so government said that 20 lakh crore rupees, that is the total package which is declared by the government, is around 10% of the total GDP, which again some of the economists contested. They thought that this 20 lakh crore rupees package which is announced by the government, it is not actually the package declared by the government, which is actually, it's not going to have any impact on the on what you can say, on the government exchequer. So but that we will discuss in the criticism for the Atmanirbhar package. Although government said that it is 10% of the total GDP, but few people believe that it is not 10%, it is only around 1% of the total GDP of the economy. So as per the economic package, it would focus more on land policies, labor, the issues of the labors, and liquidity and the laws. Right? So we can see that there are some problems in the land, there are some problems in the labor policies in India. There are some issues with the liquidity, means the money supply in the economy was less. So government tried to, what you can say, have some issue, what you can say, solve the problem of the liquidity supply in the economy. Then liquidity and laws, and also PM Modi said that it would benefit laborers. It will also benefit farmers and honest taxpayers and the MSME sector, that is the micro, small and medium enterprises and cottage industry. So the package has a more focus on these aspects of the economy, that is on the land policies, on the labor policies, on the liquidity And so these all laws will be helping or will be benefiting the laborers, farmers, and honest taxpayers, and micro, small, and medium enterprises, and also the cottage industries. Cottage industries means the industries in the at the household level, right? Again, Prime Minister says that India's self-reliance will be based on 5 pillars of economy, that is the infrastructure, technology-driven system, vibrant demography of India, and also the demand of the economy. So that is what is mentioned by a Prime Minister. And he also said that when India speaks of self-reliance, it does not advocate for self-centered system. It doesn't mean that when we want to become a self-reliant economy, so we will not be having any connection with the outer world. It doesn't mean that. Self, what you can say, reliance means, or Atmanirbhar means, that India's self-reliance, there is a concern for the world's happiness, and also cooperation at the international level, and also peace at the, what you can say, at the global level. So that is what is the meaning of the Atmanirbhar Bharat as per Prime Minister Modi. So now we will discuss about the what were all the initiatives taken by the government of India within that 20 lakh crore rupees package which was declared by the government. So we need to break down the center's Atmanirbhar package. So much of the Atmanirbhar package of the Prime Minister Narendra Modi, totaling around 20 lakh crore and elaborated over the last 5 days by Sitaraman, has been liquidity driven. So we can see that after Narendra Modi has declared the Atmanirbhar package, our finance minister has taken a tranche of the press conferences, that continuously 5 days she has taken press conferences focusing on one particular sector. Like each day she has focused on one particular sector, and she has informed about that what economic reforms have been started by the government or have been decided by the government in a particular sector. So for 5 days Sitaraman has been, whatever the initiatives have been taken by the government, this is liquidity driven. Liquidity driven means what? They tried to increase more liquidity in the market. Rather than increasing more demand in the market, they tried to increase more liquidity in the market with little burden on the exchequer. With little burden on the exchequer means what? This is not going to, what we can say, have any impact on the government's expenditure. Government is not going to spend the money, but government is trying to create liquidity in the market. It is going to supply more liquidity in the market in the form of credit guarantees, in the form of loan, in the form of concessions, in the form of, what you can say, the loan given to the MSMEs, direct money supply in the transfer of the direct transfer of the money in the accounts of the, what you can say, the vulnerable section. So that is the government's, what you can say, the way of, what you can say, reviving the Indian economy. The government also took this opportunity to repackage some of the old measures. So there were some old measures already government have been taken in the budget, in the earlier budget, and also government have already made some announcement at the earlier period. So in this Atmanirbhar package, they have been just repackaged. So these are not new announcement as such, but they have been already, the decisions which have been already taken, they have been just put up in a new package. So, and push some new reforms such as in agriculture. There were some new reforms in the agriculture, public sector enterprises, and which has been pending for long. So we will see how the whole money, the Atmanirbhar package is going to announce. The figure is not important, the amount is not important, but just try to understand that the total 20 lakh, what you can say, the crore rupees which government is going to, what you can say, spend. So in the first tranche, it was 25,000, then second 5,000, then 30,000. So there were five complete series have been taken by the finance minister, and she has declared that where this money is going to be declared by the government. So that is what is given here. So pre-announcement initiatives are under package. So pre-announced initiatives means, so before the Atmanirbhar package, which has been, what you can say, declared by the government, we can say that already the government has taken some initiatives before the announcement have been made by the government in the form of the budget and earlier policies of the government. So March 26, 2020, Finance Minister Nirmala Sitaraman announced the Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan Yojana. So this is the PM announcement, means the Prime Minister's speech which was given on the Atmanirbhar package. Before that also, some of the initiatives have been already declared by the government. So that one of the important initiative was, that is Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan Yojana. So as per this Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan Yojana, which was declared immediately after the lockdown, has been declared on 22nd of March. On March 26, Nirmala Sitaraman has announced that for vulnerable sections, that is for farmers, women, construction workers, senior citizens, widows and disabled, aims to provide for next 3 months. Means during this lockdown, these were the vulnerable, what you can say, the sections. So during lockdown, these people have been affected hardly. that is farmers, women, construction workers, senior citizens, widows and disabled. So all of them have been provided free food to the poorest of the poor. Some income support to the farmers, some income support has also been given to the farmers, that they have been, what you can say, transferred 4,000 rupees into their accounts. And for the unorganized sector workers also, some amount have been transferred into their account, that is 500 rupees have been transferred to the women Jandan account holders. So around 50 lakh medical insurance cover for the healthcare staff has also been declared by the government, that during this COVID-19, those medical staff have been affected by this COVID-19. For them, 50 lakh rupees medical insurance cover has also been declared by the government during that, what you can say, in the Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan Yojana. So, and again, March 27, Reserve Bank of India has taken some of the initiative. That is, the government have declared about the long-term repo operation that we have already discussed about it. So, TLTRO has been declared about 1,000 crore rupees. Long-term repo operations have been declared by the government. So, what is this long-term repo operation? We will discuss later on. I have already discussed with those students who were there in the class, but those who are new, who are not understanding what is this TLTRO, that we will discuss later on. But the government has, the Reserve Bank of India has declared about the 1,000 crore rupees TLTRO, that is long-term repo operation. And also government has reduced the CRR, Reserve Bank of India has reduced the CRR by 100 basis points, letting 1,30,000 crore rupees money infused in the economy. And also the marginal lending facility has also been hiked from 2% to the 3%. So marginal lending facility is also one of the important way through which the liquidity is increased in the market. So all these initiatives which have been taken by the RBI, that is TLTRO and increase in the CRR, decrease in the CRR and increase in the marginal lending facility, have been, what you can say, focused more on increasing the liquidity in the market. Because when liquidity increases, when the money supply increases in the market, then also demand increases. So that is why we can say that all these initiatives which have been taken by the government, that is liquidity driven.
Sir. Sir, ये RBI independent body है ना, तो इसका package से क्या
relation? किससे?
अभी जो आत्मनिर्भर package में इसको क्यों add किया, ये RBI का?
नहीं, मैं आत्मनिर्भर package में नहीं किया हूँ, मैंने इसको आत्मनिर्भर package में इसको add नहीं किया है, मैंने ये अभी जो मैं जो बता रहा हूँ, ये आत्मनिर्भर से पहले क्या किया था government ने, वो declare कर रहा हूँ, pre-PM announcement, so heading is that. So all these initiatives which have been taken by the RBI as well as the Pradhan Mantri, as well as the government before the Atmanirbhar package. We will discuss about the Atmanirbhar package later on. So these are the initiatives which have been taken by the government before the Atmanirbhar package have been declared. That is what I am discussing. Got it? So initiative taken by the Reserve Bank of India, of course it is not a part of that Atmanirbhar package, but it was an initiative by the RBI to help the economy. Right? Got it?
Yes.
Okay. Now on again April 27, liquidity injection by the Reserve Bank of India. That again one more, what you can say, the second version of the TLTRO is declared. That one, like again 50,000 crore rupees TLTRO has been, what it's been, increased by the RBI. So here it is 1 lakh crore and here it is again 50,000 crore. And government have, Reserve Bank of India has also decided to refinance SIDBI, NABARD and NHB. SIDBI means, that is the bank refinancing agency which gives loans to the industrial development. Then again NABARD, which gives loans into the rural areas. And so in the rural areas ke liye jo loan diya jata hai, that agency is called as NABARD. So NABARD has also, NABARD and NHB. NHB means what? National Housing Board has also been given again 50,000 crore rupees. Can anybody tell me why this, what you can say, the initiative, why the SIDBI, NABARD and NHB have been refinanced? What was the reason for refinancing SIDBI, NABARD and NHB? Of course, those who are new, who have recently joined the class, they might not be understanding it. But those who have already finished with the basics of economy and those who are in touch with the current events of the economy, I want you to answer this. Why SIDBI, NABARD and NHB have been given 50,000 crore rupees as a refinancing amount? What do you think? Yes, Sonali.
Sir, त्यांना refinancing केलं तर त्यांचं work progress पण होईल आणि
त्यांचा का why NABARD and SIDBI and NHB?
Sir, सर नाबार्ड जे आहे ते रुरल एरिया मध्ये लोन प्रोवाइड करतं, सिडबी वगैरे ते जे आहे ते म्हणजे छोट्या व्यापाऱ्यांना पण लोन देतात, त्याच्यामुळे जे एमएसएमई सेक्टर आहे ते ग्रोथ होऊ शकतो. आणि एग्रीकल्चर सेक्टरला पण लोन मिळू शकतो त्यांच्याकडून.
ओके, आणि वाय वाय एनएचबी?
सर आय डोंट नो अबाउट एनएचबी.
एनएचबी इज अ नॅशनल हाउसिंग बोर्ड. So we'll see.
हाउसिंग बोर्ड हाउसिंग सेक्टर मध्ये बऱ्याच प्रमाणात डिमॉनिटायझेशनच्या नंतर पैसा अडकलेला आहे, ते जर मार्केट मध्ये असेल तर.
हाउसिंग बोर्ड मध्ये देखील आता मोठ्या प्रमाणामध्ये काय आहे, मंदी आहे. बऱ्याच प्रमाणामध्ये बऱ्याच घरे बांधून ठेवलेल्या आहेत बिल्डर्सने, पण लोक आता ते खरेदी करत नाहीये, आणि म्हणून त्या लोकांना देखील लोन मिळायला पाहिजे, इझी लोन अवेलेबल व्हायला पाहिजे. म्हणून एनएचबी नाबार्ड आणि सिडबीला 50,000 crore रुपयेचा काय देण्यात आलेला आहे, रिफायनान्सिंग करण्यात आलेला आहे, आणि स्पेशल लिक्विडिटी फॅसिलिटी फॉर म्युच्युअल फंड दॅट इज 50,000 crore रुपीज. इथे देखील फंड ऑफ फंड नावाचे कन्सेप्ट आहे, त्या फंड ऑफ फंड कन्सेप्ट मध्ये देखील 50,000 crore रुपये गव्हर्नमेंटने वाढवण्याचा प्रयत्न केलेला आहे. सो हियर द अमाऊंट, द फिगर इज नॉट इम्पॉर्टंट, इट इज इम्पॉर्टंट दॅट हाऊ रिझर्व्ह बँक ऑफ इंडिया अँड हाऊ गव्हर्नमेंट इज ट्राईंग टू what you can say revive the economy, that is what is what you need to see here. Yes, Smriti, you want to ask something?
Sir, I just wanted to answer this. Maybe all the three are related, mainly related with the rural population of India, focusing the farmers, laborers and everybody. So refinancing them would actually affect, because of course during the lockdown these three sections were mostly affected.
Yeah, not only during the what you can say the lockdown, even before the lockdown also the MSME sector, the agriculture sector, the rural sector and even the housing sector were under distress. Right? So lockdown, say, like we can say that recently one of the like the data released by the National Survey Organization, it said that the economic slowdown had started even before the what you can say the corona epidemic had started. Right? So when the data of the 1 month before the corona or 1 month before the lockdown has been declared by the government, so that data has been already declared now. So it had shown that the Indian economic slowdown has started even before the this lockdown declared by the corona. So in that, what you can say, before the corona also, even the micro and small and medium enterprises and also the rural infrastructure, rural what you can say, the areas, agriculture sector, as well as the housing sector were facing problems. And that is why these what you can say, refinancing agencies, because these NABARD, SEBI and NHB do give loans to that specific what you can say, the sectors in India. And that is why refinancing of these agencies were required. And that is why 50,000 crore rupees have been infused into the SIDBI, NABARD and NHB. Got it?
Yes, sir, exactly.
Check.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now we will discuss about the tranche of the economic reforms which have been declared by the Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman. So Nirmala Sitharaman has taken a series of press conferences for 5 days. And in these 5 days, she has what you can say declared, or she has given the information about that what the government is going to do in the various sectors of the economy. So today we are going to discuss about the first tranche of the Atmanirbhar package, which has been what you can say declared by the government. So you can see that the government has decided to give a collateral free automatic loans to the MSME sector. Collateral free means what? Earlier what used to happen, whenever the loan is given to the MSME sector, a collateral is required. Collateral means marathi madhe apan ka mhanto ki collateral marathi madhe apan ka mhanto gahan, mhanje kahi tari zameen ka property aplyala gahan thevavi lagte. So without keeping any collateral free loans to the MSMEs, and that is also an automatic loans to the MSMEs, government to give 100% guarantee. So when the collateral is not given by the MSMEs in that sector, the government is going to give the credit guarantee. Credit guarantee means what? If the MSMEs do not return the loan back, then government will give back that loan to the NBFCs and to the banks. That is what is promised by the government, and that is what is called as credit guarantee. Credit guarantee means what? A guarantee given by the government to the what you can say the banks regarding the loan given by the commercial banks to the what you can say to the MSME sector. And also we can say the banks and NBFCs have been asked what you can say give loan up to 3 lakh crore rupees have been what you can say declared for this particular purpose. Now second is subordinate debt provide equity support to the stressed MSMEs. So those MSMEs who are already in stress, they have been also given what you can say the equity support of around 4,000 crore rupees and again 20,000 crore rupees by the government. So the first tranche has focused more on the MSME sector, like helping the MSME sector and to revive it. So equity infusion for MSME through fund of funds, mother of fund, and a few daughter funds, like mother fund and daughter funds have been given. That is 10,000 crore rupees, and also the funds of fund, that is called as 50,000 crore rupees. Funds of fund means what? Can anybody tell me what is the meaning of this funds of fund? Because this term was in the news, that government tried to, what we can say, infuse equity, that is infuse what you can say money into the MSME sector through funds of fund. So anybody can anyone knows what is this concept of funds of fund? Okay, so 10 minutes are left. I will be discussing with these 10 minutes, and after 10 minutes I will be sending you one more link so that we can continue, or we want me to continue tomorrow. What do you want? Shall we continue now or shall we continue tomorrow?
Sir, continue now only.
Okay, fine. Okay, so funds of fund means what? All of you know what are mutual funds? Can anybody tell me what is the meaning of mutual funds? Mutual funds kadhi aikla hai ka? Have you ever heard about the term mutual funds? What these are, what these mutual funds are? Gitanjali?
Yes, sir. I have heard the term, but I don't know exactly what that means.
Okay. You have heard about the term mutual?
Yes.
And fund?
Yes.
So what is the meaning of that mutual and fund? Mutual manje kay? Sarvani ekatrit pani.
Yeah.
And but fund manje kay fund?
I don't.
Yeah. So in the financial market, there is one tool called mutual funds. So what are these mutual funds actually? Because for example, suppose I want to buy a share for example, I can't buy that share with the money which I am having. So what I do, like I create a mutual fund. Mutual fund means what? Is many people come together and they create a, what you can say, a fund by themselves, right? So what you can say, if for example, some 100 people come together and they come together and they create a common fund, they create a mutual fund, and they invest that money in the various sectors. Because for example, now I want to invest in the share market, I want to invest in energy market, I want to invest in what you can say, I also want to invest in the what you can say, the solar power plant, I want to invest in the banking sector, I also want to invest in insurance sector, but I can't do it myself. So for that I need a larger fund, right? Suppose if I create a larger fund of around 100 crore rupees, so what I can do, that I can invest 20 crore rupees in energy, 20 crore rupees in banking, 20 crore in insurance, 20 crore in coal mining, 20 crore in what you can say in the infrastructure. So why I do it? I do it because to what you can say, to hedge my fund. To hedge my fund means what? To distribute the risk, right? For example, जर एनर्जी सेक्टर मध्ये जर मला प्रॉफिट नाही मिळाला तर कमीत कमी इकडे टेलिकॉम सेक्टर मध्ये तरी मिळू शकतो. जर टेलिकॉम सेक्टर जर लॉस मध्ये जर गेला तर इकडे, म्हणजे आपण काय करू शकतो की इन अदर सेक्टर्स आय कॅन गेट द बेनिफिट. सो दॅट इज वाय टू डायव्हर्सिफाय माय इन्व्हेस्टमेंट वी क्रिएट अ म्युच्युअल फंड. म्युच्युअल फंड मीन्स वॉट? की सम पीपल कम टुगेदर अँड दे गिव्ह अप व्हॉट इज द अमाऊंट, अँड दॅट म्युच्युअल फंड इज इन्व्हेस्टेड इन व्हॉट यू कॅन सी इन व्हेरियस सेक्टर्स. So sometimes what happens, ki one mutual fund invest in another mutual fund, another larger mutual fund. Got it? So that yes, is called as fund of fund. Right? So when one mutual fund invest in another mutual fund, they have to pay some taxes. Like for example, suppose when I'm paying in a mutual fund, when I'm investing in a mutual fund, I need to pay a taxes for the first mutual fund investment. But if that small mutual fund investment, if they are investing in another mutual fund, again they have to pay the tax. So now what government has decided, that suppose if any mutual fund is investing in MSME's fund of fund, then there will be no taxes on that fund of fund. That is what is declared by the government, because government wanted that such type of fund of fund equity should be infused into the MSME sector. What is this fund of fund concept?
Yes, sir. And what about the mother fund and daughter fund concept? Like, is it like the original fund and the
later invested fund? Right. Mother fund and daughter fund. You are right.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Similarly, because one mutual fund investing in another mutual fund, that is what is called as fund of fund. That is what is mentioned here. Mother fund and few daughter funds to operate it. The government contribution likely to be around 10,000 crore rupees. So government is also going to invest in such type of fund of fund, that is 10,000 crore rupees, and private investment is expected around 50,000 crore rupees. Alright, so fund of fund means what? Ki investing one mutual fund, when one mutual fund invest in another mutual fund, that is called as fund of fund. And when one mutual fund invest in another mutual fund, there is a tax levied by the government. So here in this case, government has decided not to levy any tax if one mutual fund is investing in MSME mutual fund, to encourage or to attract more mutual fund or more equity infusion in the MSME sector. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Check it. Now next is EPF support, that is employee provident fund support will be given to the workers, that is 2500 crore rupees. Again, EPF fund, all of you know what is EPF? That government gives a provident fund to the employees and employers, so that government is going to help it. Then again, special liquidity scheme is also mentioned here. So we will discuss about the liquidity. Those who have not done with the basics of the economy, you will come to know about it, liquidity scheme. But remember that liquidity will be given into NBFCs, housing finance, what you can say, the companies, and also microfinance institutions by 30,000 crore rupees. So special liquidity scheme is given to the NBFCs, at housing finance companies, and as well as microfinance institutions. So if anyone don't know what are these NBFCs and housing finance companies and microfinance institutions, we will discuss it about later on. But you remember that amount will be given to these companies which are helping, what you can say, reviving the economy, or which will help in reviving the economy. Next is partial credit guarantee is also given to the NBFC, because we have seen that NBFC was in stress in the last 2-3 years. So non-banking financial companies, they have also under stress in the last 2-3 years. So a special support or a special, what you can say, credit guarantee is also been given to NBFCs by the government of 40,000 crore rupees. And again, liquidity injection by REC, PFC, for the REC means, what you can say, these are for the power distribution companies, that is DISCOMs. Because we have seen that power distribution companies are also under stress during this time. So they will also be given around 90,000 crore rupees for their operation cost. Right? So you can see that all these initiatives which have been taken by, which has been declared by the first tranche of the Atmanirbhar package, it has been focused more on the MSME sector, and also it has focused more on the NBFCs, and it has focused on the, what you can say, the power distribution companies, which are the small and medium enterprises in India. Got it? So the first tranche was focusing more on the MSME. That is what it is mentioned, that the first dose is the liquidity, that is MSME get a mega guarantee, while the package is unlikely to create a much stress on the fiscal exchequer. Means what you can, this, all these things which have been, what you can say, declared by the government here, we can see that it is not going to affect the government expenditure anyway, because here the government is not spending any money. Only the government has asked the banks and asked, what you can say, the other people to, what you can say, infuse more money into the MSME sector. So here the government is not giving money to the MSME sector. Government has created an environment to ask the private people to invest into the MSME sector. And also the banks and housing finance companies and commercial banks and NBFCs, which will help to get the loan to the MSME sector. So that is what is mentioned here, that while the package is unlikely to create a much stress for the fiscal exchequer, as most of the measures are focused on off-balance sheet support. Off-balance sheet support means what? They are not going to, you can say, have any impact on the government budget. So off-balance sheet support through credit guarantees and tax deferment. So that support have been given by credit guarantee, and that support have been given by, what you can say, tax deferment. Deferment means what? It's giving some time to pay the tax, and the success of the scheme is predicted on these measures working as a multiplier to improve the risk appetite of lenders. So government is expected that this initiative will multiply the liquidity in the market, and this will help, or this will increase the appetite for the lenders to more, what you can say, lend more money and catalyze the fresh funding of the distressed smaller firms. Okay? So it will help in catalyzing the fresh funding to the distressed smaller firms. Means all the smaller firms, that is MSME sector, which have been distressed, they will get some, what you can say, the encouragement by this first series of the economic reforms started by the government. So this is all about the first tranche of the economic reforms declared by the Atmanirbhar package by Nirmala Sitharaman on the first day. So what government has declared on the second day, that we will discuss in the next session. If you have any doubts about this first tranche, you can ask me. We have 1 minute left, so we can discuss with that. If you have any doubt, then we can go to the next session. I'll be sending you the new link again, so you can join to that next session. Any doubts? यस एनी डाउट्स स्मृति रूपाली कहते हैं सर्वना
यस सर
ओके फाइन सो वी विल स्टॉप हियर यस
लॉन्ग फॉर्म ऑफ आरईसी एंड पीएफसी
These are actually that is electricity companies. That is the REC and PFC for the power distribution companies. We don't need to about. We just need to remember that the government has also helping the power distribution companies because even power distribution companies have also been what you can say facing the distress during this time. That is why government has helped the power distribution companies. No need of going to the REC and PFCs.